Welcome to the 101 voice training for the 101 link, desktop call assistant. In this video, we will show you how to use the Windows application 101 link, the desktop call assistant for 101 voice. Once you install and launch the application, you will need to sign in using the same username and password you use to log into the 101 voice web portal. If you have trouble logging in, please contact 101 voice support for assistance. We recommend checking the Keep Me Logged In box to avoid having to log in every time you launch the application. When you log in for the first time, you'll be taken to the settings. Go ahead and click on your phone line to select it. If you have more than one line, which may be the case if, for example, you use your mobile app, select the line for your desk phone. If your phone is online, the other sections of the application should now be available. You will also be able to click the icon in the top right to turn Do Not Disturb on and off for your line. Please note that you may not have access to all 101 link features shown in this video, depending on the features in your 101 voice account. At any time, you can change your field of view by clicking and dragging on any edge or corner of the window to resize the application. As you scroll down through the rest of the settings tab, if your phone has been assigned to any call queues, you'll see a list of those queues here. You can sign in and out of the queues by clicking on them. If the icon turns green, you're signed in. If it turns gray, you're signed out. And below that, we have voicemail transcription. When you get a new voicemail, this feature will convert that voicemail to text and send it to the email address provided. To enable this feature, simply check the Send to Email checkbox and enter your email address. Now let's look at the other sections of the app. You'll notice as you mouse over each icon that it will temporarily expand and show the name of that section. On the far left, we have calls. To use 101 link to make a call, enter a phone number or the name of one of your contacts. We'll show you how to add contacts later on. Once you've entered the number, click Call. First, your own phone will ring. Once you answer it, the system will make the call to the number you entered. When you're on a call or have a call coming in, you'll see that information under Active Calls. Next to the active call on the right, you'll have two icons. The one with the arrows pointing in opposite directions is the transfer icon. To transfer a call, just click the icon and you'll notice the call button up here will change to a transfer button. Enter the number or extension or contact's name and click Transfer. Clicking the envelope icon will send the call to your voicemail. Below Active Calls, you will see a list of your recent calls. As you mouse over each entry, you'll see two icons on the right. Clicking the handset icon will call that number, which works the same as the Make a Call feature. First, your phone will ring, and when you answer it, the system will call this number. Clicking the speech bubble icon will send a text message to that number. We'll cover text messages later on. Now let's move to the next section, which is your inbox. This is where you will find your voicemails, text messages, and instant messages. Voicemails will have this speaker icon on the left, and if you have voicemail transcription turned on, it will show up here in addition to the email. You can use these icons on the right to play the message, restart the message, or download the message as a WAV file. Text messages will have the green SMS icon, and instant messages will have the blue IM icon. In both cases, you can reply to the message by mousing over and clicking the speech bubble icon, or call the person by clicking the handset icon. The next section is contacts. 101 link for Windows can import contacts from either Outlook or Gmail. To import your contacts, just click the three dots up here and select Download from Outlook or Download from Gmail. An extension for Outlook will be installed alongside 101 link, which allows access to your contacts. For Gmail, you will have to sign into your Gmail account and grant 101 link permission to access your contacts. You will also have the option to delete your contacts here. To call one of your contacts, simply mouse over the contact and then click the phone icon. There is a search function at the bottom which does exactly that. You can search by phone number or name. Next, we have My Team, which will show any coworkers that have been added to your team. Teams must be set up by 101 voice support at this time. To create or modify your team, just open a support ticket and one of our staff will be happy to assist you. You can call one of your team members by clicking the handset icon on the right or send an instant message by clicking the speech bubble icon. After you click the icon, just type your message and click send, similar to other instant messaging applications you may have used before. If you want to send a group message, scroll up to the top and click the plus sign to add more team members to the conversation. And of course, you can continue an existing conversation by selecting it in your inbox as we showed you earlier. To the left of each team member's name, you'll see a star icon. Clicking the star will make that team member a favorite, which keeps them at the top of the list. To remove favorite status, just click the star again. This other icon will vary depending on the state of that person's phone. Green means they are idle, and gray means the phone is offline. The red icon means they've turned on Do Not Disturb, The handset with an arrow means they have either an incoming or outgoing call, depending on the direction of the arrow. Finally, we have the SMS section. This is where you can send text messages, much like you would using your mobile phone. First, click the plus sign, and then enter a phone number or the name of one of your contacts. Like instant messaging, you can add multiple numbers to send a group message. Then simply type your text message in the field at the bottom and click send. You can also continue a previous conversation by selecting it in your inbox as we showed you earlier. And that covers everything the 101 Link application for Windows can do. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact 101 Voice Support at 408-739-1000 or email support@101voice.com.